Hello everyone, in this video I want to talk a little bit about adding some artificial sunlight to your landscape images. This means for this foggy morning image we will add some beautiful golden hour light with a custom made sun star on the right side, and we will also add some more atmospheric fog to this image. So let's start. As you can see, I'm in the Camera Raw editor of Photoshop. First off, this time I'm not changing the profile since Adobe Color does a pretty good job here, but in the basic panel I want to adjust the white balance right away. As I said, I want to have some kind of golden hour light, so that means we need to boost the temperature a bit. That looks good. Then I want to work on the exposure of this image. Right now it looks super dark. That's mostly because of all those shadows, especially in the upper part of the image. So to counter that, I'm simply going to boost them. That makes the image a lot brighter and helps tremendously. For more brightness, I'm going to boost the whites. Let's see at what point the overexposure kicks in. Seems to be around here. Now it's a little overexposed, but for now I want to keep it that way. And next, let's also add a bit of texture. For a softer look, I'm going to drop the clarity. Although I said I do want to add some fog, I'm going to boost the dehaze just a little bit. The main reason here is to just dehaze the upper and bottom part of the image. For the center part, I will use local adjustments to add back some more fog. But first off, let's also introduce some more vibrance. I do want this image to be saturated. That looks nice. Now, with the basic stuff out of the way, let's jump into the local adjustments. And as usual, I want to start with the gradiated filters. Let's go from top to bottom. And here in the top part, I don't like how those highlights stand out of this area. So I'm going to drop them all the way and thus get a nice blue sky up there. Then I have another gradiated filter for the upper part. And that's because I don't really like the heavy contrast in those trees up there. So I try to just bring down the contrast, and thus I create some more artificial fog, and also I can brighten up the shadows up there. Alright, nice. Then for the near foreground, I do want to make it a little darker by bringing down the exposure just a bit. Perfect. That's it for the gradiated filters. Now, of course, I also have applied the free radial filters. I guess let's start with the big one in the center. And as I said, I want to introduce some more artificial fog in here. And for images like this, adding some negative dehaze works really well, as you will see. I can boost it quite a bit. Let's see. I think that's a good spot. Now, this will not only introduce more fog, but also will brighten up this part and helps me just adding more and more light to this image. Then there is this radial filter left on the right side. Again, I do want to increase the fog in this area, so let's boost the blacks. And again, I'm dropping the dehaze. And since I want some golden hour light coming in from the right side, I'm going to boost the temperature. Now, this doesn't do too much, but every little bit helps here. That's it for the local adjustments. Then let's go over the color grading real quick. I'm going to start in the color mixer tab with the hue. And I do want to change the green tones a little bit. Therefore, I'm going to drop the yellow hue. Just like that. It's a very subtle change. It's mainly in the background right there, so that's okay, I guess. For the saturation, I do want to boost the yellow saturation. And at the same time, I'm going to drop the green saturation slightly. Perfect. Now let's do the split toning. Here I'm just going for the highlights, where I want to apply a warm color tone. Again, we do want to have some golden hour light, so somewhere in this range should look pretty good. But of course, the saturation is way too much, so let's bring that down. Okay. It does seem like the colors are still a bit on the weaker side, So I'm also going into the calibration tab all the way down. Here with the blue primary hue, I'm going to drop it. And I also want to boost the saturation here. All right, that was helpful. As you can see, we do have some more orange, yellowish color tones in the grass in the foreground. That looks pretty cool. Now, here we have done the base raw adjustments in the camera raw editor. We still haven't added that much sunlight, but with those adjustments out of the way, we can focus on adding some cool looking light. So let's open it up in Photoshop. First off, I do have to clean up this image a bit. Unfortunately, the placement of this shield is very, very unlucky for me because it's super hard to get rid of. So for this reason, I'm going to duplicate the background layer. So I just have a backup because I will mess something up here, I guess. And then I'm just carefully working my way from the bottom up. First off, the spot healing brush does work quite good for the first half, I guess. But I will need to use the clone stem tool as well. So that will take a while. Okay, that's far from perfect, but for showcase purposes, it's okay, I guess. Then next up, let's work on the sunlight. For this reason, I'm going to first add some more glow. So let's create a new layer, switch the blending mode to hard light. Then I'm grabbing the brush by pressing B, and I'm also dropping the brush opacity to around 10% to not make this effect too strong. For the foreground color, you can see I have picked a very bright color tone with a warm color cast to reproduce this golden hour light. And then I'm just carefully painting in on the right side. And I'm painting over all those bright spots where the light is supposed to come through. All right, cool. You might notice there is a rather bright spot right here, which is shining through the tree branches. At this point, it does look a little bit strange, but I do want to put in a sun star over this position. For this exact reason, a few years back, I shot my own sun star overlays, which you can find in the description. So let me place the sun star in this image real quick. Here you can see it's shot with a black background. That means all I need to do to get rid of the black tones is simply change the blending mode from normal to screen. With this done, I can now just drag this sun star around where I want it and of course adjust the size a bit, just like this. If you're looking closely, you will still see an edge right there. Again, that's not a big deal, just apply a levels adjustment layer. And make sure it only affects the sunstar layer by holding down Alt key and clicking between those two layers. And now I'm simply going to push up the black point. Just like that. And you can see the edge is gone. I might make the sunstar a little smaller. Just like that. And let's see. That's a good spot right there. Perfect. That looks much, much better already. Now I do want to add some more light by doing a little bit of dodging. For this reason, I'm going to add a new layer, switch the blending mode to overlay, and then I'm using the TK panel plugin to create luminosity masks. In this case, I do want to make those areas a little brighter without affecting the shadows, and also on the left side. So I will need a lights mask, I guess. You can see how this one nicely targets those areas which I want to change. So I'm going to add this layer mask to our new overlay layer. Then again, with the brush tool, I'm going to increase the brush opacity here though. I am painting in some more brightness here. Just like that. Let's do the same thing on the other side. All right, that looks really cool. I do think I need to target the midtones as well, not only the lights. So let's add another new layer. Again, go with the overlay blending mode, use the TK panel plugin, And this time, let's take a look at the midtones. Here you can see we have a much wider range. So let's use this luminosity mask. And again, with the brush tool, I am carefully painting over those areas here. Perfect. So at this point, I do think the colors look a little weak. In this case, I'm using a vibrance adjustment layer to change that. Here, let's just boost the vibrance a bit. All right. Now we got quite a bunch of layers here. I do want to merge those, but I don't want to lose all those steps right here. Again, I'm using the TK panel plugin to solve this. Here I can simply say merge visible and I get all those layers merged into a new layer right here. So I don't have to worry about the steps I did previously. With this new layer selected, I'm now going to apply a few Nick Collection filters. Okay, on the right side you can see I already have a set of filters I do want to apply here. First off, I'm using the Indian Summer filter to get those golden orange tones in the foliage in the foreground. We could make it a little stronger maybe, just like that. Then I have added the polarization filter, which again would just add some subtle saturation to everything. And finally, there is the glamour glow, which of course just adds a bit of glow, which works great for the soft look. And also, I do have added some glow warmth, which helps with the sunlight. So let's apply it like this. Perfect. Now there's one last thing I want to do, and that is to change the yellow tones. Again, I'm using an adjustment layer. This time, however, I'm going to use the hue saturation one. Here I'm going to pick the yellow tones, which I want to make more vibrant by bringing up the saturation. Just like that. You might think the foreground is too saturated now, and you're totally right. I'm just focusing on this area around the sun, which right now looks really good. So finally, let's mask out a bit of the foreground from this last adjustment layer using a black brush. Just like that. And that's it for creating artificial sunlight and for editing this image. I hope this was interesting and helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comments, and thank you so much for watching this video.